Hi Pisces, and welcome to your monthly tarot reading for October. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope that you're doing well. And this is a general reading for any sun, moon, or rising Pisces, and we can get a sense of the energies and messages for you in October so that you can plan accordingly. So I've already shuffled quite a bit. I'm just going to give it a few more shuffles and we will get started. Faith in the process. And that's really a wonderful card to have faith in the process of what you're trying to accomplish in life, in what you're dreaming about, your hopes, your goals. It's important to have faith in yourself, but also to believe in what the universe is going to do, and to believe in what divine source, God, spirit is looking out for and working behind the scenes. And so faith in the process is that even when times are challenging and you feel low and you feel uninspired and you feel that you don't have the energy or the passion to move forward, take a break and take some time to think about where you are and where you can go. And if you're down, you can, talk to people, you can read, you can take time to pray or to meditate or to get involved in yoga. But there's a sense of really, incrementally trying to pick yourself up to a higher vibration, to a higher frequency, and turning a lot of your faith over into the process, into what's happening in the bigger picture of the world and of the universe, and of that when we shape our thoughts and when we believe things in a certain way, then I think that the universe is listening to how we're, or at least paying attention to how we think. And so that's really the first step, is to have a mindset where you're going to like release your worry and let the powers that be above move us in the right direction. And also I think that it's a sense when you have faith in the process, you also have faith in your own inner instinct and your intuition. That's a huge part as well. So I love this card because it's one that people can access and can think about as you reach bumps in the road. And you're thinking, gosh, maybe this isn't going to work out. But if you just can take a moment and a step back and just to say, you know, there's an old adage, things happen for a reason. And perhaps the reason is the bigger design that's going on. So, again, as I would always say, one step at a time and move your vibrational frequency into one notch up from where you were. So, you know, faith in the process. Have faith in that everything is going to work out. It certainly reminds me of the Star card and having that optimism that everything's going to turn out okay. So let's take a look at our emotional or spiritual self. Okay. Hope. Your loved ones in the spirit world know where to reach out if they see you're at a low point. Whether you're caught up in a difficult situation or struggling with someone specific in your life, there is always hope. And again, hope, the message of the Star card, and having faith in the process. You have to have that underlying hope that everything is going to turn out okay, and to listen to messages from spirit, to listen to messages from the universe that are pop up all around you that you may be oblivious to. And hope is essential. And it's hard to watch people who might have lost hope. And I think the first place is you have to have hope in yourself And you have to have the belief that you are capable of doing anything that you want to the physical degree possible. And again, it starts with your mindset of how you look at life, how you look at issues, how you look at your relationships with others, and how you interact. And to have hope, certainly colors the day. And so if you are, if you start off with a point, if you know that things are a little tough, or things are not quite where they should be, if you can just start with a point, well, I believe, with a positive affirmation, I believe that this is going to turn out this way. And to specifically say it, I mean, it's a positive affirmation. But to have hope is, you know, there's a lot of love within having hope. So love yourself, love the universe and spirit and everything above, the behind the scenes, and don't lose your hope. Don't lose your hope. I mean, easy to say, because sometimes people feel crushed by obligations and challenged by ill health or things going wrong or by job situations, finances. But if you can sit down and think about things and do some prayer, meditation, time for yourself, meet with someone to talk things through, and that can help. And you have to find a way to have the hope always present. So let's take a look at body. Ask your body for a message. Please help me hear your messages. Please guide me in honoring and respecting my body's needs. So this is a reminder for the week to, let's see if I can get that, to pay attention to what your body's telling you. How are you feeling? Are you tired? Are you high energy? Are you having trouble sleeping? Are you getting enough sleep? Are you, you know, exfoliating the dead skin from your face, you know, getting a scrub or something? But all the little things, pay attention to. And certainly, if you feel worn down, then take some extra time to nap or to rest. If you feel that you have not done the best job eating for the week, don't punish yourself, but try to focus you know, on just doing, having a better meal, the next meal of making it healthier. Ask your body for a message. Do we really have to ask our body for a message? Because it often tells us what it needs. You know, because when you don't feel well physically, it affects, it just affects your day. I mean, you could be grumpy, you could be just quiet and not as productive as you had hoped. So I think that the body has a way of forcing its way through and telling us sometimes what it needs. But from your end, you know, if I just learned something yesterday from a massage therapist that for joint pain, that Indian gooseberry is something that has been helpful to people. So then it can help tremors or just knee pain or things like that. So, you know, that's something that I will investigate, that I'll look into. But don't be afraid to do some research and, you know, keep your vessel in the best shape possible, and it's sending you messages all the time through energy, through how you feel and how your mindset is. I mean, everything, again, it's all connected, it's all balance, and finding the ways to keep each piece in check, our mind, spiritual self, our body. So let's get a practice area for the week. Declutter. You'll feel better and more focused if you'll take the time to clear away the clutter from your living and workspace. Donate what you can to help others who may need your items. Be sure to keep your schedule uncluttered as well. Powerful card, decluttering, simplifying. When you don't have to worry about the mess in the house because you have less, you know, that frees up time for you to do fun things and the things that are passionate for you and enthusiastic. And so ask yourself the next time you're at the craft store or at the craft festival and you see all these things that you're hoping that you're, I'd like to get a couple of these, and then you put them on the shelf. Do you really need them? And that's the question to ask. Do I really need this? How is this going to add value to my life? And, you know, the old saying, or well, not the old saying, but the kind of the criteria is if you haven't worn something in 1 or 2 years, chances are you're not going to wear it. Give it to someone who may need it. The same goes with books. If you've read a book, share it with someone else, you know, let someone else benefit from books. And it can apply to anything. Is when you can reduce the amount of clutter, the amount of stuff that we have, it creates more time for you because you're not spending time organizing the stuff. And I would encourage you, there's a website called The Minimalists, and it's two guys who really changed their lives, and they're perhaps maybe too minimalist for some, but it really goes to how you can create more space and openness within your life when you need less, when you want for less, and fewer clothes. In fact, the guy from that minimalist, forgot his name, of course, he has like one pair of jeans, and he keeps them clean. He has a couple shirts and a pair of shoes and a pair of tennis shoes. Now, it may not be practical for all because some people need a suit when they are the trial attorney and they have to look presentable. So you have to find the level of uncluttered-ness that can work for you. But it is a freeing and such a beneficial task to take on, because it really, once you're able to do the donate, give away, and trash, well, donate and give away the same thing. I'm trying to think of what I'm saying. Try recycle or reuse. You get the drift. But there are many people who can benefit from clothes or furniture or things or computers not being used. So if you can take 20 minutes and to declutter just a section, because what people often say is just so overwhelming to do my house or it's my apartment or whatever it may be, just take a small section, whether it's a drawer or a dresser drawer, and declutter. Make your piles, send it off, put, you know, donate it to charity. So let's pick an overarching idea to think about and to close the reading and to meditate and to contemplate for the week of the 8th. And the card is Shine. And there's a lot of shine on the reflection. Sorry for that. So it's a beautiful peacock. And the swirling colors, and really this message is to let your light shine to others and let your uniqueness share that with people, because be true to who you are. And when you give a smile and you're empathetic and you are actively being kind to someone, you get that back. And so that's one way of letting a light shine. But really, this is about individuality. It's about if you're quirky, be quirky. You know, there are other quirky people out there. If you are assertive and driven and, you know, a workaholic, so be it. let yourself shine. Let who you are really come through so that people can get a sense of what makes you tick and that they can get a sense of the real you. And it's just, it's a beautiful card to think about, which is let love come out of you. Let that shine. Let your light illuminate and bring warmth to others. So I think it's a beautiful reading and so many good ideas here, particularly hope, of having hope and having faith in the process. Trust, having trust in yourself, having trust in divine source, God, or spirit, or the universe. Listening to your body, getting your body in the best shape possible. And decluttering, simplifying your life, and improving someone else's, perhaps, and, you know, let your light shine. Let your individuality come through. Be an authentic you. Be the real you. And people will gravitate towards you. So I hope that you found something helpful here within this weekly oracle reading. And I wish you a very blessed, healthy, and balanced week. If you enjoyed this reading, please like, share, or comment. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. It's a great way to stay connected and to show support for the time that it takes to make videos. So I appreciate it. So just subscribe if you're new or been watching. So that would be awesome. And take care, and I will see you next week. Bye-bye.